Back-to-back cast smallies.
Yep. Huge smallie monster. Here's where he's hanging out. His house is right between those two rocks out there. They're all eating right
now. Simple tarp setup today. I went with a Adirondack-ish style. I have this piece right here.
If it's raining really bad, you can tie it down like this, and it covers it really well. It's not too bad of a night and you want to have it out like this, you get a bunch of protection under there. You can tie it off to like a tree over there. You can use a stick going down to the ground.
That it might be hard because it's all rocks, so I can't just pound a stick into the ground and hold it up. Isn't supposed to rain, so I might just honestly leave it tucked back like this, but yeah, pretty cozy. This is probably one of the quickest raised beds I've ever made because it's all pine, so it's super straight. All I had to do was take off all the little pokies. I don't know if you can see it in this shot. Fire pit's gonna be right there. And then Carson's gotta set up his spot soon. He's out getting firewood right now. And then Steve's gonna be here soon too, so it's gonna really start feeling like camp. And it's just getting dark. Carson caught 3 or 4 smallmouths. Cool though, he's catching fish already.
caveman chicken. Big D, come.
It's cooked all the way through.
Rock.
See if any little ants come out.
There we go.
Oh yeah.
Hello, friends.
Those things are gonna be looking for a home tonight.
Beautiful out there.
Alright folks, welcome to the Bassmasters Pro-Am. Today we're on the Black River in Jackson County.
Dramatic.
Mm-hmm. Alright, here we go folks. We got a nice little smallmouth bass. No shortage of these guys here in this river. They like these rocks. They're feeding on my Ned rig. I'm gonna guess they eat a steady diet of crayfish here.
Oh,
the red pine, some common identification. Its bark is red, it's kind of scaly and peely, soft.
Good?
Mm-hmm.
Biggest friend with them?
Yeah.
Just buttered this thing up this week with a stone.
One tripod is gonna go right here. One's gonna go right there. So we need about three of those size.
I have a cool idea. I'm not gonna tell you about it. I'm just gonna show you it when I do it.
Little pro tip for you, everybody. So I keep this with me. You guys have seen me use this before, my Sawyer Mini. Good water filter here. This is how I pack it. The Sawyer itself comes with this, and it's super easy to pack 16 ounces. Can fit it in my bag super easy. I attach it to this. This would give me another liter right here. If you're like me, and you like to drink a lot of water throughout the day and use it for cooking everything, you're gonna wanna get one of these. They're super affordable. And it's nice to not have to go filter a bunch of water and make a bunch of trips. And that's what we're gonna go do right now. I'm gonna go fill up my water. Be enough water to last four guys for a little bit. Same shirt as last video.
Same entire outfit.
Never even took it off.
Only shirt I've ever seen.
haven't changed since. I've been out in the woods the whole time.
He swam up river.
You want to go head to head? Start cutting, boys. Ash. And it's been dying for the last 4 or 5 years, so it's going to be already dry to go in the fire. It is dying due to the emerald ash borer. On some of this bark, you can see D-shaped holes.
Looks like your bed's getting a little bit comfier tonight.
It's quite sandy, actually. Oh, that should be better.
Added this up here to put my feet on in the middle of the night when I'd like take my boots off and we're sitting around the fire. Get my feet up off the ground.
Stick set up here, raise my bed off the ground a couple inches. Kind of pave the outside of my sleeping bag area. Just keep the sand and dirt away from me as much as possible. And my favorite addition is the new tarp I got from Drew. Gonna have to retire the blue one.
This is a brand new Coleman sleeping bag. It was actually made for 40 degrees. It got down to like 38 last night. I was a little cold for like the last hour, so it was all right. And I just got a little 6x8 tarp here, and then underneath right here.
Okay. Dude, I'm gonna bring up a hole.
bad. Not bad.
That's a big boy.
That's a nice one.
Nice, Lano.
Handled him.
This slow guy.
Back to back cast. Let's put him off this side here.
Nice fish. Get him in.
Easily the biggest one yet.
Yeah.
Nice.
Ooh, he hit it.
He ran right into it. Dude, nice bass though.
On repeat. Release.
Right at about 63 degrees Fahrenheit.
Oh, holy
risk.
That's gotta be chilly.
My ass hit a rock on the flip over.
That was freezing, dude.
It's awesome.
More meat. More smoke.
Yeah. You really think that's gonna fit on there?
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Dude, we got 2 pounds of ground beef.
Yeah, that's true. I should have put more.
It's not what I'm worried about. I'm gonna say you're gonna dirt half that. Yeah, that's so much on there.
This is the jack pine, and a fun fact about the jack pine is they only regenerate during fire events.
When the heat and intensity of the flames gets hot enough to a certain temperature, the cones actually open up and disperse the seeds.
Dude, it's a nice fish.
Oh, Lano, let's go.
It's a nice fish.
Let's go, dude.
Great padding, slept great all night. Happy I did it.
See you next time, folks.